And drumroll please. In this video, I'm going to show you guys how I make all my YouTube thumbnails by using the tool PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. First off, I just gotta say thank you because most of you guys have been requesting this in the comments down below. How do I make my thumbnails? There's a lot of great tools out there on how you can make thumbnails, maybe using Canva or even Photoshop or Illustrator, but what I tend to use is PowerPoint. So with that being said, I'm gonna show you guys right now how I make my thumbnails. On my screen, I just have almost every single thumbnail that I've created for my YouTube channel. Most of these are just raw edited images with like my headshot and then the text. So if you're interested in getting this file, I'm gonna have a link to it in the description below, but I'm actually gonna show you guys from scratch how I make a YouTube thumbnail and a YouTube thumbnail for this video that you're seeing right here. So basically my thought process when creating a thumbnail is one, what is the YouTube video about? First, I gotta understand that and what I really wanna emphasize on the thumbnail. You can even take images of yourself while you're recording. Let's say you wanna be like, check this out, or like this right here, or like this. You just got to do a bunch of different poses that you think you might use for a thumbnail image if you want to include your own headshot, and then that way you just have a library of headshots that you can use for the future for your thumbnails. I've actually been doing a series showing you guys how to remove the background of your headshot images, how to fix all the blemishes of your faces, how to whiten your teeth, how to even like lighten up your eyes. So if you guys haven't seen those videos yet, make sure to check those out. Once you have that all figured out, you can then just drag in a headshot image. So what I want to do is I probably want to drag in this headshot image that I see right here. So as you can see here, if I double click into this image, you're going to see that I do have a glow effect on this headshot image right here. I have no shadows or anything. You can really get creative with it. If you want to add a shadow to your headshot, feel free. I like to add kind of like just a white glow rim around my headshots just so it pops in the YouTube thumbnails. That's just also what I've been seeing on YouTube. So I may change that in the future, but that's just what I've been doing for now. That's really all I have for this image. Maybe I'll brighten it up, so I can always go here and then go to picture corrections and then go to brightness, contrast. If I really want to make the picture brighter, if it's a little dark at the moment, you always have that option. But once I'm done doing that, I then can just place it where I think it should go. And so I'm just going to copy these styles real quick. So this is the format I want to copy on this image right here. Maybe I'll actually place it on this side. And I'm going to show you guys why I maybe want to place my headshot on this side instead of this side of the thumbnail. Is because how YouTube works is there's going to be like this time bar down here. And so that's going to be blocking part of the thumbnail. Then there's also going to be the actual amount of time of how long your video is. Whatever content that's really important that you want to make sure people see, put it in that upper left hand corner of your YouTube thumbnail so that people can easily see it and so that YouTube is not blocking it when you're seeing that time bar or the time at the bottom right. So I am going to put my headshot on the right side right here, and then I'm just going to flip it and then just kind of line it up like so, and I'm going to move this text out. All right, so for the next step, what you want to do is really figure out what you want your background image to be. This is going to be kind of like the game changer for the thumbnails, because if you look here, I had a Halloween themed kind of thumbnail, and this one actually wasn't too hard to make. All I had to do was search Halloween on like unsplash.com, and then I just did a couple of outlines here, put it in like that cool pumpkin kind of scooper, and then just add in some text saying like what the video is about, and then I was done. It was that simple. So imagery is key here when you're trying to make really good looking thumbnails. So try to do less work for yourself by finding really good imagery. And how you can do that is just by going on unsplash.com, pexels.com, or even pixabay.com. So right now I'm going to take some time and I'm going to try to find a really cool image that I think might look nice for this how to create this thumbnail picture. So why don't I do that right now, and then I'll get back to you guys. All right, so I took some time to look for a really good image for this thumbnail, and this is the one that kind of caught my eye. Now usually when you are creating a thumbnail, you want to base it off of the theme of whatever the video is about. In this case, the video is actually about how to create this thumbnail that you're seeing before you clicked on this video, so it's a little bit harder for me to figure out like what picture do I pick. But let's say you're doing about like travel. tractors or something, you're going off, pick like maybe a picture about like a farm or something, or something on brand with whatever you're talking about in the video, or maybe even like something that's from the video. So just keep that in mind when you're trying to figure out that background image. For this case, it's a little bit different, but just stick with me and you'll understand kind of my thought process as I continue with this. So I kind of have this picture right here because, you know, I'm designing something on a screen, need to use a laptop for that. Pretty colorful, vibrant. I really like that. I love anything that pops and has a lot of color to it. So also keep that in mind. All right, so now that I have this image, now what I want to do is I kind of just want to fill it up in that screen and mess around with the cropping to see kind of how I want to position it. So I'm going to keep this type of information up here, and then I'm actually going to get rid of this background image right here. Just delete that. And now I'm just going to increase this to be pretty large, not going to lie, and we'll go like so. And then I'll crop it just so that it's at 16:9. You just want to make sure it's the same size as your slide, because that's the same dimensions that your thumbnails are going to be. That's looking actually pretty good. I like how I cropped that image, and now I can send that to back. And okay, so maybe I'm going to flip this. And honestly, creating thumbnails, it's not the easiest thing always. Like, two of the most important things, at least that I've always heard, is that titles and thumbnails are the most important things when creating videos, other than obviously providing helpful content. But if you don't have those two things down really well, no one's going to even see your video. So you got to make sure you can hone this. So that's another reason why I just want to share this with you guys. So I'm just going to be playing around with this as I go and talking with you guys as I'm figuring this out together. And just know that not all my thumbnails I create, I can create them in like a couple of seconds. Some of them will take like several hours, or I'll look at it and then I'll even upload it to YouTube and then I'll see how it kind of looks. And then I'm like, it doesn't look as nice. So I kind of change it up. So I may even change this later, but let's keep going with this. Now I want to say create this thumbnail, or how to create this thumbnail. I'm going to take this text right here, and you want to just find like a text that you're comfortable with that matches the style of kind of your channel. So, you know, if you're like a rock and roll channel, maybe you don't want this type of font, but I just like this type of font. It's just super bold, super just kind of clean and minimalistic. So I really like it. And then what I'll always do is add like a text shadow just so the text pops. Obviously, you don't always have to add a text shadow, but that's what I usually do for my text. And then another thing that I learned is that you don't want all your text to be the same color. Sometimes you want as many different colors going on your thumbnail as possible, just to really make it like stand out and pop and not just look kind of neutral. So that's another thing I've been trying to play around with, is different colors for maybe like different words to really emphasize certain things. Let's see. So how to create this thumbnail. I think I'm just gonna have text similar to that. So I'm just gonna say how to create this thumbnail. And I'm just gonna make that like so. The font size I have for this is just 88. So I'm just gonna maybe decrease the size a little bit, maybe make it 80. You wanna make sure your font's pretty big, because the smaller it is, it's gonna be so hard for people to see it. Like, trust me, you don't wanna have too small a font. And you also don't want that many words on a thumbnail to begin with, because people are more visual when it comes to thumbnails. So just keep that in mind as well. So I actually like adding in this kind of rectangle gradient. And how I did that is I just went to insert shapes and then square or rectangle, you know, whatever shape it might be, make that. And then this is just a gradient of two black colors, and the first one's at position of 0, transparency of 0, and brightness 0. And then this position is at 71%, and then transparency of 100%, and brightness 0%. And these are just both color blacks. So, and you can just add in as many colors as you want. And so I'm just gonna add this in here, and this just allows me to make my text stand out more and not have the background image like drown out my text. So that's just another thing. And so I might actually flip this as well, just so it's easier for people to read the text I have. And let's see here. I'm liking this so far because it's looking pretty colorful. I might actually decrease the size of this a little bit and scoot this over. All right, I'm liking that so far. Maybe I'll increase this a little bit like that. And sometimes I like to actually, like, people might not realize this, but I actually rotate an image even though it's like cropped off like this, just so I can have my pointer finger pointing upwards a little bit more. How to create this thumbnail. I try to stay away from like centering text, just because it's usually hard for people to read centered text versus if it's aligned to the left. And I'm just thinking out loud as I'm going through with this. So I'm probably going to make this color match. I'm just gonna highlight this text color and then do eyedropper and see maybe that color. And then I'll do this color as, let's see, let's maybe do like this color. That's a little too dark. Maybe we'll make it a little brighter. We'll do, that's just too many colors going on. I know I said you need color, but that's just too much. Let's just make it all the same color. A couple things I like to play around with is one, I like to play around with how closely my text is spaced out between each other and increasing and decreasing certain text boxes. So like, I wanna make sure thumbnails emphasize. So that's like a good size. I wanna keep it that size. And now I just need to like figure out how to get this text to kind of align well. So I'm gonna play around with this a little bit and then I'll get back to you guys. All right, so as you can see, I sped this up so you guys weren't watching the entire process, but making thumbnails is no easy task and it can take a lot of time. Right now, I see on my clock it's showing I've been recording for about an hour. For you guys, it might just show like 10 seconds. I'm not sure how long I'm gonna make this go through in terms of like understanding my process, but as you can see there, I messed around with the headshot. I wasn't feeling it, so I wanted to switch it out. I also changed up this text to be more of a gradient color. And then I also just moved this upward. I've got some stars here that you can just get from inserting icons and then added a gradient. And then I also added in this cool mouse icon that I also added in as icon. And you can also add a glow effect to this as well. This is just kind of my thought process when I am making thumbnails. It's not really the most enjoyable or prettiest thing to watch to understand how I come up with them. You just got to play around with them, really make sure like things flow nicely and be patient with it is my biggest advice. And also just try to pick really cool imagery. Like that's what's gonna really start your inspiration for your thumbnails. You need to have good imagery, good fonts, maybe include a headshot of yourself if you want to. If not, that's fine too. And also make sure it's not too busy. As you saw there, as I sped it up, I was trying to include like multiple images of myself and I was like, what am I doing? Why would I do that? So I got rid of that instantly and just try to keep it nice and simple. And now if I put this in presentation mode, it looks a lot nicer. And I actually see that I forgot to scoot that down a little bit. So I'm gonna scoot this down just a tad and then go back in presentation mode. And now I really like this thumbnail and how it turned out. It's super colorful. If I was looking at this, and I can also test this by uploading to YouTube and seeing how it's gonna look first, I would be intrigued to click on this thumbnail because I would wanna know how to make this thumbnail that I'm seeing right here. So if you guys did like this video, make sure you give a thumbs up. I know this was a very requested video by a lot of you, so I wanted to give back to you guys by showing you how I actually make my thumbnails. And also, if you haven't already, please make sure to subscribe to this channel. It's free to do, so I'd really appreciate that support. Also, if you are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, I actually offer a course about PowerPoint on Udemy, so I have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.